about making our community a decent place to live. And as many of y'all know, come here, sister. This is one of our sisters here. I know I gotta pick on you. But our sister right here, she's one of the favorite ones that we love talking to every week. She loves the Final Call newspaper. She love, don't you love it, right? She said, I love looking at the pictures. But on the real, these one of our sisters and our brothers that we love talking to that have widely accepted the message that we bring every week. So the street soldiers, the brothers around the corner who will be joining us shortly, they've been saying that they wanted us to do something for the children. And we told them that we would, and so now we're making our word bond today. And so we just want to thank the community, the residents of Kings Row Apartments for inviting us over here to do this. And also we want to let you all know is that, you see all these brothers and sisters, you see the sisters in those garments right there? You see them over there? You see the brothers over there? But these sisters in particular, I want y'all to make sure that y'all talk to them and engage them, because they have a couple of things they want to share with you all. This is your family out here.
I just wanted to thank everybody for coming out. And I wanted the community to know that y'all the one that spearheaded. The brothers like Xavier, the brothers, the street, the soldiers out here, y'all the one, the children out here, y'all the one that spearheaded this. Because we come in to serve. As a good servant, we listening to what y'all saying, we listening to what you want. We listening to what's not here. And if we listen well enough, then we know what we need to do in order to serve you properly. So this is the beginning. We just want to introduce that we here as family.
Assalamu alaikum. I think Brother Lennon said all that need to be said. Just want to extend our gratitude on y'all accepting us into the neighborhood. We love y'all. We've been taught that, you know, our best people are in the street. And we know what we're looking at when we see y'all. So whatever God has blessed me with, I want to give it right back to y'all. Anything I know that can help, I want to give it right back to y'all. I'm in real estate, and I can tell you I've seen gentrification happen. And I've seen something that we think is nothing be leveled and something beautiful be brought up again. So whenever we want to make this what we want to make it, I'm ready to help, and we can do it. So whatever you guys need from me, I ain't just talking about money. The children hit me up for money, but knowledge, I'm here to share. Everything that I know, I'm to serve our people. So we love y'all. I'm not big on words like Brother Lynn, but we're going to have our brother Jesse come up and say some words. He's coming back. But I'm going to be at this booth right behind us. If you got any questions, I want to explain the importance of home ownership, of land ownership, just of owning real estate. A lot of us are not educated in that perspective, but if you got any questions, feel free to hit me up. I'll be located right behind you at that booth. All right, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Come on.
Come on. There we go, the real leader. Let's give him a round of applause, my brother. And the message, see, these are the type of brothers that we have talked to on a weekly basis. And the thing about it is, the reason we don't judge these brothers is because they sharper than most of us, man. They wise, they got an entrepreneurial mind, they want to own something. So whenever they see Brother Chad, they always talking about how to make investments and how to do things right. So at the end of the day, we want to just let you all know, man, we appreciate y'all, brothers. We thank you all for welcoming us into your community, because this is where you live at. And we want to let y'all know, anytime y'all need something, man, we here for y'all, brother. My brother right here, come on up here, man. Yes, sir, brother. Now, you know you got to come up here. We didn't talk to you for many hours on the steps. Let's give him a round of applause. Yeah. This is a generation born feeling trying to act shy. But this is what Make Our Community a Decent Place to Live is all about. It's not about us coming here telling you all what you need to do. It's about you all knowing that you all are the leaders and the rulers of this area, and you take time. So you, when you look in the eyes of all these babies, this is what it's all about. It's not about us. It's all about them. Yes, sir. Come on. Come on. There we go. The real leader. Let's give him a round of applause, my brother. And the message, see, these are the type of brothers that we have talked to on a weekly basis. And the thing about it is, the reason we don't judge these brothers is because they sharper than most of us, man. They wise, they got an entrepreneurial mind, they want to own something. So whenever they see Brother Chad, they always talking about how to make investments and how to do things right. So at the end of the day, we want to just let you all know, man, we appreciate y'all, brothers. We thank you all for welcoming us into your community, because this is where you live at. And we want to let y'all know, anytime y'all need something, man, we here for y'all, brother. My brother right here, come on up here, man. Yes, sir, brother. Now, you know you got to come up here. We didn't talk to you for many hours on the steps. Let's give him a round of applause. Yeah. This is a generation born feelers trying to act shy. But this is what Make Our Community a Decent Place to Live is all about. It's not about us coming here telling you all what you need to do. It's about you all knowing that you all are the leaders and the rulers of this area, and you take time. So you, when you look in the eyes of all these babies, this is what it's all about. It's not about us. It's all about them. Now, real quick, you know, when we asked for people that wanted to support, somehow, some way, our email and our packet of what we've been blessed to do in this community, it got to the e-desk of the council member of this district, Councilmember Dwight Barkins. And I don't know what event he was at, but he called me. It was a lot of noise in the background. And he stopped what he was doing to call to say that he wants to support this because of the work that we're doing. So our brother was the first one. Now, y'all know it take a long time to get checks sometime from City Hall, right? The next morning, when they got to the office, he made sure that we got his donation immediately. So we want to welcome District D Councilmember Dwight Barkins to the microphone to say a few words.
Brothers, there was a guy named Ovi Duncantel who was making a difference in my community. And to this day, he knows what I feel about him. I do anything for him. And I listen to Mr. Duncantel, and today I'm your city council member. With God's plans, other things can happen. And I learned from him to become a public servant and not a politician. That's why I give. That's why I give time. That's why I cut yards for senior citizens. That's why I have a second chance jobs program to help people who look like me, you, and others who made mistakes, even nonviolent ex-felons, to give them a second chance. Everybody deserves it. So I'm big on helping our community.
Now, this is a true story, and Brother Lynn will bear me witness. When we first knocked on her door, Mama Juanita wasn't trying to hear nothing we had to say. She was baking her, you was cleaning chitlins, I think, and baking tea cakes at the same time. We knocked on her door. She was like, I'm not interested. All we did was tell her, thank you very much for your time, ma'am. We came back a couple more times. Next thing you know, she came to the door to greet us. Next thing you know, brother, she invited us into the air conditioner. Next thing you know, we were sitting on the couch. Next thing you know, she was too tired to open the door and told us to open it ourselves. Since that time, this has been the number one supporting elder. Wait.
I want to first give glory to my high power God, Jesus Christ. But I just want to say, when they asked me to come over to speak today, I didn't know what I was going to say. This is what I believe, that we are all sparrows. We are all God's children, and we were put here on this earth for a purpose. It's not all about what can somebody do for me, it's what I can do for somebody. You know, sometimes a lot of the kids come to my place, and the little smaller kids, they don't know. They come in and they got 2 cents, and they say, I want a cool bag, or I want a pickle, or I want a cupcake. And I look in their hand and I say, you know, God, it ain't even about this money. It's about showing love. And so I tell them, baby, get that. Get what you want. And if it's 1 or 2 come in and 3 got money and 2 don't, I'm not going to let them 2 leave without nothing. And my blessings are steady flowing. So I want to be able to bless my community as well. And I just thank for the guys for coming by and giving me that encouragement. Because when I first started doing it, I was just doing it to get some extra money. I don't do it for the money no more. I do it because of the love that has been shown to me. And I hope that I can share it with somebody else.
At last, we got to give a testimony from one of our wonderful favorite residents. Brother Lynn thought he was a coffee expert until we knocked on this door. This lady here is a wizard of coffee. So I want you to introduce yourself to the people and just tell them what you think about what's been going on. She's the one that serves lunches in the community center to the children every day from 11 to 1, right? Y'all need to give her a round of applause. She's the one that serves the city lunches. And every time we knock on her door, she comes out on her porch and talk to us. So you got to just say just a few words.
How y'all doing? My name is Patricia Renaud. I don't turn down nobody. I'm going to talk to a stranger. I don't care. I'm a God's person. I'm going to talk to anybody who want to talk. On the bus, anywhere I go, I'm talking. That's just how I am. Very, very generous and very, very just like to talk. I love to talk. Everybody knows I'm Roger. These babies, I've been on these babies all my life. I love these kids. I love being over here. That's why I haven't left yet. I just like to be around people, and these people here just make me feel good. I done met so many people out here, not even from where I'm from, but I love them. They know I love them. I'm away from what they call a dead end, South Park, Texas, but I don't claim it. It's just where I was raised at. I'm over here now. But a whole different group of people that I love, just like family to me. And that's how it's supposed to be. Everybody's supposed to get along. Tell everybody, children, what's right and what's not right. And that's what I do. Some of them don't listen, but that's all right. I'm going to keep on. Boy, you know what I'm talking about. Girl, you know what I'm talking about. You better stop. You want to come stay with me for a week? Just 1 week. Come stay with me for 1 week. That's all I ask. But I love being around here. And I love these brothers. These are my brothers here. They be trying to preach to me. I be listening to them. That's what them packages. Don't you eat this? I say, okay. My coffee, I love my coffee. I'm supposed to have some coffee out here.
I'm waiting on it.
I'm gonna go make some coffee for them.
We'll be right here.
Y'all got some cups?
We got some cups.
Okay.
Yeah,
I got them.
Yes,
they're gonna be full of energy when y'all get home tonight. All of them. Thank y'all for coming too.
All right, real quick. So again, we want to thank you all as the Kings Row community for allowing
Kings Row.
We want to thank you all for inviting us and allowing us into your, you go say Kings Row? Okay. Allowing us into your community. And we thank you all for being a part of this. This is all about you all. It has nothing to do with us. It's about us serving you all.
Okay, say it again.
My name is Aaron Brown.
What's his name next to you?
And my cousin's name. My cousin's name is Cameron.
Okay, how old is Cameron?
Woody.
Woody, okay. Y'all having a good time?
Yes.
What's been y'all favorite part?
They selling popcorn, snow cone.
Yeah. What's your favorite flavor?
Hi, my name is Ashley. I'm 9 years old and I like it because we get to have fun.
And what are you having fun doing?
Everything.
Okay, what's been your favorite part?
Moonwalk.
Moonwalk
and the song.
My name is Diamond Miley, and I am 10 years old. So the part that I like over here is when we go to the dropping room and go play.
That's
the part that I like.
And what else are you doing that's having fun?
I'm just having fun, listening to music, learning how to be a DJ. And I've been learning how to help people.
Yeah.
And that song.
Yes, ma'am.
My name is Jaquincy Brown, and I am 12 years old, and I like the trampoline that was over there in Coney, and I like the music and the DJ.
Yeah.
And the funny part was when the man was playing the guitar.
Yeah, you like that.
All right,
cool.
My name is Mecca, and I'm 11. My favorite part was the snow cone machine and the moonwalk. That's really cool that they came out here and helped us because it was really nothing to do over here but play football and fight and jump and play soccer or volleyball, something like that. Or we could just play on the play over there on the playground. That was really it. So that really saved us and it really saved us from boredness. Really helped us.
Thank you.
I'm 6 years old.
What's your name?
Jonathan Enriquez.
And what you like the most about today?
The park and
the moonwalk. Yeah. I see you got a snow cone too.
And
okay.